The first rule of Mars life is, don't talk about Mars life. Hi everyone, I'm Ian O'Neill, space producer for Discovery News, and I've commandeered the DNews video studio to share some news that, well, kind of flew under the radar. In case you didn't notice, by all the rovers and satellites we have orbiting Mars, we are fascinated with the red planet. We can't live there without a spacesuit because the air is too thin and the planet is bathed in radiation, but it's the closest thing we've got to Earth in the whole of the solar system. There's been a recent flurry of science results from NASA's Mars rovers. These results suggest that not only was there water on Mars, it was very wet, the water existed in a liquid state, and it was pH neutral, so it's almost safe to drink. So when you collect all the evidence, it's not such a stretch of the imagination to think that basic life forms like single-celled microbes like bacteria once mingled in the Mars rock and soil millions of years ago. The next step would be to send a robot, or even humans if we could be bothered, to collect a sample of rock and launch it back to Earth. That way, geologists and astrobiologists can analyze the samples and look for ancient fossils and microbes. But nature is already one step ahead. Mars, like every other planet in the solar system, is smashed by asteroids, and some of the Martian impacts have been so energetic that chunks of the Martian crust have been blasted into space. After drifting for possibly millions of years, these rocks may fall to Earth as meteorites, so we're actually getting bits of rock from Mars landing on Earth. We know of hundreds of Mars meteorite examples, and these precious commodities have been studied extensively. This pretty cool concept has led to the hypothesis of panspermia, where life may hitch a ride on meteorites and spread from planet to planet like a highly infectious interplanetary herpes. But that's a whole different story. Anyway, back to these new results. In February, NASA scientists published a paper discussing tiny tunnels and holes inside a 30-pound Mars meteorite. They said these structures are similar to bioalteration textures in glasses found on Earth formed by terrestrial microorganisms. They also used terms like biogenic origins and biotic activity. But at no point in the paper do they mention the word life. You'd expect every tabloid paper in the world to have this splashed across their front pages, but the news just kind of floated by. Other scientists praised the NASA researchers for avoiding speculative comments about finding signs of life on Mars. Just because this particular meteorite has tiny features that may have been created by tiny microbes doesn't mean that they were. This is science at its finest. This is tantalizing evidence for life on Mars, but more studies are needed, and the researchers are keenly aware of this. And probably the only way that we can get proof is when we can actually analyze a microbe's DNA, which is probably good enough reasons for humans to actually finally settle on the Martian surface carrying a microscope and a forensics kit. Are you as excited about this finding as I am? Let us know in the comments below and subscribe to DNews for more science news videos every day of the week.